In this video, what do you find when the man says hello?
Hello!
After a while, the similar sound comes back. So why is sound
hello!
Coming back after it is being said once? Consider this animation. In this animation, you find a boy is throwing a ball on the wall in front of him. Now after hitting the wall, the ball is bouncing back towards the boy. So do you think something similar happens in case of sound as well? Well, the answer is yes. When sound hits an obstacle like a wall, it hits the wall and it bounces back. For example, in empty rooms and caves, this effect will be understandable. So this phenomenon is known as the reflection of sound. So let us talk about how reflection of sound takes place. Consider a sound wave traveling towards an obstacle. This is the obstacle, let's say. So consider a sound wave that is traveling towards the obstacle as shown by the arrow on the wave. This sound wave that is traveling towards the obstacle is known as the incident wave. Now after the incident wave hits the obstacle, like we said, it'll bounce back. So this wave bounces back and keeps traveling in the opposite direction. This wave is known as the reflected wave. So if we draw a perpendicular at this point, that is the point of incidence, that perpendicular is known as the normal. And the plane on which the incident wave, the reflected wave, and the normal at the point of incidence lie is known as the plane of incidence. So the angle that is made by the incident wave and the normal is known as the angle of incidence shown by the letter I. And the angle that is made by the normal and the reflected wave is known as the angle of reflection shown by the letter R. Now consider this animation. In this animation, a boy and his friend are standing at a distance apart, and the boy throws a ball on the ground such that it reaches his friend after bouncing on the ground. Notice the angle of incidence and the angle of reflection. Now, if they come closer and the boy throws the same ball on the ground and it reaches his friend at a different angle, notice that the angle of reflection has also changed from the previous case. So what do you think will happen if the boy throws the ball vertically? If the boy throws the ball vertically up and down, the ball keeps bouncing back in the same direction. That is, it bounces back vertically up. So how can we relate the angle of throwing of the ball and the angle at which it is bouncing up? Or in other words, how can we relate the angle of incidence with the angle of reflection? Let us find out. There are certain laws of reflection that sound follows. These laws of reflection states that the incident wave, the reflected wave, and the normal at the point of incidence lie on the same plane. This is the first law that sound follows during reflection. And what is the second? The second law states that the angle of incidence, that is I, is always equal to the angle of reflection, that is angle R. So in other words, I is always equal to R. Now you must be wondering how we can make these statements. Let us verify these statements. Consider this animation, which is showing a very simple experiment. In this experiment, two hollow tubes have been taken along with a clock. Now let's say you move the tube on the left, let's call it tube 1, at a particular angle. In this case, let's say 20 degrees. Now you will notice if you keep your ear at the other end of tube 2, you will be able to hear the sound distinctly at 20 degrees. Now let us consider another angle. If tube 1 is moved and kept at an angle of, let's say, 40 degrees, and you keep the clock at the end of tube 1, and you listen from the end of tube 2 at the same angle of 40 degrees, you are able to hear the sound of ticking of the clock distinctly. So what does this tell us? This tells us that the angle of incidence of the sound wave is always equal to the angle of reflection. And as you can see from this, the incident wave, the reflected wave, and the normal that is shown by the 0-degree line lies on the same plane. So we have verified the laws of reflection of sound. So we can say that sound gets reflected. Now when sound gets reflected, it reaches our ears after some time. So what happens then? Notice this animation. In this animation, Jack is standing near a wall and he's shouting out hello. Now when he shouts hello, he's able to hear it only once. Now consider the following animation. Here, Jones is standing at a farther distance from the wall. When Jones says hello, he notices that he hears the sound of his voice twice. Once when he says hello,
hello,
and another time after a brief time gap. So what do you think is happening? Why is Jones hearing his voice twice, but Jack is hearing it only once? Now let us get into the science behind this. For our ears to distinguish between the sound and its reflection, that is, for our ears to distinguish the sound that we say and the sound that is reflected back of an obstacle, there should be a minimum lag or a minimum gap of 0.1 seconds between the sound and its reflection. So if the gap between these two is less than 0.1 seconds, we will not be able to distinguish between the two sounds. But if it is more than 0.1 seconds, we will be able to distinguish between the two sounds. So as I just mentioned, the sensation of sound persists in our ear for about 0.1 seconds. This is known as the persistence of hearing. Now, if you remember what I showed you in the first video, when the man shouts out hello, he is able to hear his sound twice.
Hello!
Once when he shouts, and once again when the sound is reflected and comes back to him.
Hello!
So this sound that we can clearly perceive after reflection is known as an echo. So you must be wondering, what should be the minimum distance from you to the obstacle for you to hear an echo? Let us calculate that minimum distance. Consider this animation where this boy is standing at a certain distance from the wall, that is the obstacle, and he's shouting out hello.
Hello.
Let us say
hello,
that the distance from the boy to the obstacle is D. Now you will notice that when he says hello, the sound is traveling all the way to the wall, that is a distance D, and the sound is getting reflected and it is traveling back to the boy, also a distance D. So the total distance traveled by sound is 2D meters. The total distance traveled by sound is 2D meters. And as we just learnt, the minimum time that is required to distinguish between sound and its reflection is 0.1 seconds. So can we calculate the minimum distance for this? Now consider this picture. We just learned that the total distance being traveled by the sound is 2d meters. The minimum time that should be allowed to distinguish between sound and its reflection is 0.1 seconds. And the speed of sound is 330 meters per second. Now, do you recall the relation between speed, time, and distance? The relation is distance is equal to speed into time. So with this relation, do you think we'll be able to find out what the minimum distance is? Let us find out. Speed is equal to distance upon time. So distance, as I mentioned, is equal to speed into time. So we can say that 2d, which was the distance, total distance traveled by sound, is equal to 330, that is the speed of sound, into 0.1, that is the time taken, and this is coming out to be equal to 33 meters. So sound is traveling a total distance of 33 meters, that is from the speaker to the obstacle and from the obstacle back to the speaker. So what is the one-way distance? The one-way distance, that is the distance between the speaker and the obstacle, is 16.5 meters. So what can we conclude from this? That the minimum distance that should be allowed between the speaker and the wall or an obstacle is 16.5 meters to allow an echo to be heard. So you must recall in the previous case where Jack, who was standing very close to a wall, he was not able to hear his voice twice. Why do you think it was happening? It was happening because Jack was standing at a distance much lesser than 16.5 meters. However, Jones, he was standing at a distance of more than 16.5 meters. And that is why Jones was able to hear his voice twice. Once when he said
hello,
it, and once
hello,
when it got reflected. So let's take a quick recap of what we learned. We learned that any sound, when it hits an obstacle, is reflected. After it bounces back. This reflection is guided by certain laws. What were those laws? The first law was the incident wave, that is the wave which is traveling towards the obstacle. The reflected wave, that is the wave that is bouncing back and traveling in the opposite direction. And the normal at the point of incidence, that is the perpendicular that is drawn at that point. These lie in the same plane. And what was the second law? The second law stated that the angle of incidence, that is the angle between the incident wave and the normal, was equal to the angle of reflection, that is the angle between the reflected ray and the normal. Further, what did we learn? We learned that the clear sound after reflection that we hear is known as an echo. And what was the condition for echo to be heard? For an echo to be heard, the minimum time gap between the sound and its reflection should be more than 0.1 seconds. And what is to be the minimum distance between the speaker and the obstacle? The minimum distance for an echo to be heard is 16.5 meters.